Yes, let us discuss one of the landmark laws passed by Parliament, IBC. In the current context, it is a very, very relevant and very, very important law. Insolvency and bankruptcy code. Insolvency and bankruptcy code. Right. Now tell me, guys, have you ever tried approaching for a loan sometime in the bank? Can you just close the door, please? You have tried, or your parents have tried? I believe that we all are from middle class families, and generally in a middle class family, the dreams, so to speak, one is to own a house. Generally, general trend, you keep asking somebody, one is to own a house, own a car, right? Own a home for sure. That is your own home, of course, where you have a house, and of course the car. In respect of the car, if you see, one day Ratan Tata was going on the road and he stopped at a signal in Mumbai, and it was raining heavily, and he just saw to the right there was husband, wife and two children getting drenched in the rain on a two-wheeler. So he said, I want to do something for them, because ultimately the ultimate middle class dream would be to own a car and of course to own a home. One of the sort of most common dreams, or the two of the most common dreams, would be to do that. Now he said, now let me do something nice and let me create something where it is quite reasonable and economical, where they can buy a car. So that's why he started the Nano. But Nano was a failure because of the marketing campaign. They used one word which would prick even any middle class family. They used this word cheap. India's cheapest car. Correct? Now tell me, would you buy it when I say India's cheapest car? Which means you own India's cheapest car. So the mindset of the middle class family is very simple, that anyway I am buying a car, it's a one-time investment. Why do I need to go for a cheap one? Why don't I go? They could have used the word economical, affordable, reasonable, something. But some stupid fellow there, PR fellow, he said, no, let's use the word cheap. And he admitted, Ratan Tata admitted, that one word destroyed my dreams of making Nano India's most economical car. I should not have used the word cheap. The PR agents told, but I should have, the better sense should have prevailed. And in fact, see, that one word. So if you have, and we as middle class people also sometimes think what other people think, unfortunately. So when I say you own India's cheapest car, no. So I might as well take one more loan, pay EMI for 3 more years, but let me buy a good car, not India's cheapest car. But nevertheless, it was a genuine attempt by Ratan Tata to do something for this such people who have just two-wheelers and have four people sitting on the two-wheeler getting drenched in the rain. He felt very sad and genuinely wanted to do something for them. And he created a very economical car where 1.5 lakh rupees you can buy. I could have bought one Nano. That is one part of the story. Second part, if you want to buy a house, or let's say you want an educational loan, those of you who have gone for a loan will know the pains of getting a loan, right? So they will make you run from pillar to post. It is not easy to get a loan, right? So though you are extremely honest and you have shown all the documentation, but still it's very, very difficult to get a loan. Why? Because there are a lot of documentation stuff, and the thing is, they generally intrinsically believe that you cannot repay. That's the problem. You cannot repay. Now compare that with these big industrialists, big businessmen. Vijay Mallya, Shri Vijay Mallya, he is the main hero in this entire IBC. So Vijay Mallya goes to the court, to the banks. Now he's going to have to go to the court now. He goes to the bank and he says, this is my model that I have for Kingfisher. Please ensure that you give a loan. Now the thing is, for every business to run, you should have a business plan. Correct? You should have a business plan. Now we need to understand how easy it is to get a loan. Now, there is one word called crony capitalism. Have you heard? What is crony capitalism? Crony means? Crony. Crony? Friend. Crony is a friend. Capitalism. So where the capitalists are hand in glove, collude with the people who give money. You have seen so many scams now. Your ILFS scam, your Bhushan Steel, we'll discuss all that. So if you see, everything is based on crony capitalism. And yesterday we saw ILFS 90,000 crore. Sorry, this 91,000 crore. Will you really think that will be recovered? No. And whose money is that, by the way? Your money and my money. We have deposited in the bank. Okay, we'll get our money back. That's a different issue. But actually 91,000 is gone from the economy. Think about it. And where are these directors? All abroad. So if you see, it's shameful that the crony capitalism is to such an extent that they get loans so easily. So easily they get loans and we can't get. So why is it that for us it's very difficult to get a loan and repayment, they'll just extricate even 1 rupee. And if we don't repay, they'll send their recovery agents. All rowdies. They'll send it to us where they will extract, they'll throw the property to the, throw all that is in the house, they'll humiliate us in front of everyone. So that is the rampant thing, and because of which even farmer suicides are on the rise. And normal people who cannot, there are so many suicide cases that you see that they could not take the financial burden, so the only thing is they relieve themselves of their misery by killing themselves. On the other hand, there are people like Vijay Mallya who mint money. So think about it, you are a loan, you are a bank manager who has the power to issue a loan. So you go there, a CA student, you ask for an education loan or you ask for a house loan. And how much they make you run from pillar to post as against somebody with a business plan that may or may not even work. For example, let's take Vijay Mallya's case. Now, again, the Vijay Mallya case was preceded by one of the good intentions that, again, the middle class mentality is, I need to fly at least once in my life. I'm talking about 10 years ago. Now it has become very affordable. When you were kids, and let's say you had not used the flight, or even now you may not have, you know, gone in the flight, that is immaterial. But what I'm saying is that dream you had, that once I had to sit on the flight, correct? So I thought we had to sit on the flight, not inside. I was asking my parents, where will they tie me? Correct? So that was one of my innocent doubts. So if you see, the crux of the issue is that you want to fly once in your life. Now, that time, I'm talking about 30, 40 years ago, traveling was a very, very costly affair. So around 30 years ago, a round trip on an aeroplane would cost anywhere between 30 to 40,000 in today's money. The normal middle class families like you and me, you and I, could not afford this. So if you remember, all our trips used to be train or bus. So 7-day trip, in that 5 days, you are dying in the train only. I'm going to Delhi, how many days? 7 days. Where are you dying? Train. 2.5 days coming. What did you see? 2 days, Jantar Mantar, here and there, all those things. And that Agra I saw and came back. That's it. So it 7 to 10 day trip, half the trip was during the in the train. Because flying was not an option for us, it was very expensive. As simple as that. Now, one man decided to change it. That was Captain Gopinath. He said, I want to make flying extremely affordable. So he created Deccan Air. So Deccan Air, he said, why do I need all these luxury and all that? I don't want. For a 1 hour trip, for a 45 minute flight, he said, I don't want a 400 seater, 500 seater. Let's skip it, 150 seater. Because if I have a small plane, like Jet Airways, Bangalore, flight is just around 150 seater. Now anyway, it's not there. So it was less than 150 seater. It was a good small plane, compact. Right? So there, what is it? You will not have to pay landing charges to the aviation authority. Landing charges are a bomb. So he realized that landing charges, if I don't pay, I can pass on the benefit to the customer. So let's keep small flights, no big ones, small ones. Fine. That is point number one. Second, for a 45 minute flight, why do I need the luxury? So he removed all the recliner seats and made, 3+3. I don't need any luxury. I can aramse travel 45 minutes. Third, he said, why do I need food? You can eat and go, no, 45 minutes you can sit there, nothing will happen. But you should provide food also. So he said, let's keep exorbitant rates. Nobody should buy. We'll just keep 3 sandwiches, that's it. 700 rupees, 800 rupees. So you should be a fool to actually buy the sandwich. He just kept 3. And water bottles and all, again, water you can carry. Otherwise, you drink and come. 45 minutes, nothing will happen. Right? Then again, if you want to buy water, again, charge a bomb, 200 rupees, 300 rupees. And then, why for a flight of 150 people, why do you need 5-6 air hostesses? Correct? Not needed. So they said just 1 or 2. 1 is enough actually. But again, 2 maximum. That's what he did. He cut down everything. Pilot and all, you can't tell why 2 needed. Yeah? Pilot, yes. Pilot you need. Why you need pilot? No. Pilots are needed. Pilot he didn't touch. The other fellows, no? The air hostesses and the air host. It's not air host, it's a purser. So those fellows, so those guys are there. They cut down everything. Then he said budget. It's budget 2000, 3000. So you could travel, you could fly to Hyderabad round trip for 3000 rupees. And in the bus it would cost you 2000 anyway. Now it opened up the middle class dream. Everybody started traveling in flight. And this Deccan Air changed the dynamics of, the travel in terms of flying. So it changed the airline industry and everybody started slashing their prices. Now this flamboyant young guy comes. He says, let me change the way things are done here in our country. Flamboyant, stinking rich. Balance brought down from dad. Correct? So he has loads of money. So they think, let me just splurge the money on something which is something dynamic, let me start. So he was so flamboyant that he was called as the king of good times. Correct? So he said, let me start this, Kingfisher Airline. So he took over from Deccan Air. And anyway, this guy couldn't sustain further, unfortunately, because of a lot of technical issues, Captain Gopinath. So unfortunately, that dream was shattered and he had to sell it. But Kingfisher said, don't worry, we are Indians and I feel that every middle class Indian should travel in luxury. Forget about this recliner, whatever, the dying like one bus there. Only that bus handle is not there in Deccan Air. Everything else was there. Correct? So let us travel. Otherwise, people will stand also there. Yeah, reservation. Actually, he removed all the seat numbers. So that best method of seat reservation, kerchief, throw it. That's what it is. It was actually like a bus, but it was flying. That's it. So he said, no, let me change everything and Indians should travel in luxury. And believe it or not, he made recliner seats and he made slightly broader seats. And he said, I'll charge the same. No problem. I'll charge little higher, but it'll be the same. Don't worry. And he did all these things. And he said, first recliner seats, slightly reclining and broader seats. And for the first time ever in the domestic, what do you say, flying experience across the world, what did he introduce? Entertainment system. Each, what do you say, seat had an entertainment system. Imagine how much it would have cost him, right? Each one had an entertainment system. And in India, as I told you, we jump when we hear the word free. So again, as shameless as we are, in the other Deccan Air and all, no chocolate, nothing. Correct? Earlier, if you remember, they used to give chocolates. They used to hold out chocolates. Again, in India, it doesn't work. Ideally, you should take what? 1 or 2. Not 1 or 2. But we take 1 or 2 handfuls. That's the problem. Correct? As shameless as we are, that's the problem. But Deccan Air stopped all those. No chocolate and all that. Shit, 45 minutes. First of all, it's like a small shareholder director. Making your director only is a big thing. Right? You're flying. That is only a big thing. No chocolate and all. For 1300, what you'll get? Nothing. So, come. It was fair enough. This guy started giving 5 stars and all that. 5 star dairy milk. I'm not kidding. First 2-3 months. And that too, not 1 or 2. In a tray. Right? You could take as many as you want. So, the luxury component may change, but our mentality will never change. So, 1 or 2 5 star again became 1 or 2 handfuls. Right? Again, we used to take. That's it. He said, okay, let them travel in luxury. Then he's the only, what do you say, CEO of the entire world, he used to handpick his air hostesses. I'm not kidding. He used to have personal interviews with them, handpick the air hostesses. So if you see, And he had a criteria also, it was extremely sexist. He had a criteria 18 years to 22, that's it. So these should be the air hostesses and I will handpick them. So all, and he said each plane should have at least around 3 to 4 air hostesses to look after the customers. And he said, yes, now it comes a luxury part, free. What free? He gave a free book to every passenger, free book with the Kingfisher branding, free pen. And the best part was, for the entertainment system, you needed earphones. He provided headphones. And the best part was, you could take them home. And if I'm giving all this for 3000 rupees, won't you jump? Yes. Correct? All people, everybody. Even I have some 2 headsets at home. Right? A pen is also there, I still remember. Right? A booklet and a pen and 2. A pouch also they gave. Everything free. Take it, it's free. And for 3000 rupees, it was a steal. Everybody started using. But no one knew that the cost of that per seat was 4,500 rupees. When the cost per seat is 4,500 and the revenue that are getting is 3000, even if it's a scalable model, when the cost per seat is only 4,500, will you ever make profit? No. We are all students of costing. When the per, what is not even fixed overhead, it is the variable cost itself is 4,500. And you are charging some 2.5-3K, you will never ever recover the variable cost. Forget about the fixed cost, landing charge and all are separate. Now, this was the business model of Kingfisher. And the best part was, you thought he was pumping in his own money. But no, with this business model, he went to all banks. Everybody was fascinated by the dream that he showed. He said, I am going to make the middle class travel in luxury. Bank managers themselves are middle class men, middle class people. They're like, wow, amazing. We really want to ensure that this is happening. Without even seeing anything, what did they do? They sanctioned the loan. 1000 crore, 2000 crore, 3000, 7000, 8000 crore loan. He took your own money and gave you free stuff for which you have already paid. That's the best part. And took money also for that. 3000 rupees, you know, your airfare. So if you see what he did was, and again, how did he get loans so easily? No questions asked, nothing. And if you see the business model, there was nothing. Rahul Bajaj of the Bajaj Group, in one of the forums, he told that Kingfisher did not have any business model, it only had models. That's true. Did not have any business model. And how would you give loan, sanction loan just like that? It is unbelievable. And the non-performing asset of the airline industry or anything for that matter was staggering. It was almost around 12%, the non-performing asset. I'll just play a short video on the crony capitalism thing, which there was a discussion on NDTV that time. It was quite some time ago. Let me just quickly figure that out where it is. It was based on the rising bad debts. Check it out.
Public sector banks. Look at it from 2014-15 upwards. The non-performing assets, bad bank, bad debts are rising, particularly in public sector banks.
So check it out. What is the public sector bank NPA? From 3.5% in 15, it's gone up to 12%. Public sector bank, your money, my money, SBI, all those fellows. Private sector banks will never give money, obviously, because there the funding is from private parties and other things. They will never give. Public sector banks, government money, right? And also, of course, you know, the other people, and they're more or less like almost like government employees. So if you see left, right, center, give loan. Check it out.
It's almost 12% now. Private sector banks, not such a big volume in terms of absolute numbers, but also they're much more careful. Is this an indication of what they call crony capitalism and the whole system is giving loans to big industrialists? But public sector banks are in a bit of trouble.
Let me you raise a good question, but I think we should be a little bit careful here.
Yeah.
I think the standard view of public sector banks is, you know, there's a lot of crony capitalism, whatever, yeah. Right? But let's just, I think, step back and say one thing, right? When India was having its boom period, right? When a lot of the infrastructure got built, I mean, the private sector banks never participated. So in some senses, you're only looking at one side of the problem. I think the public sector banks financed it and so. Second, I think one has to be really careful about viewing this as a morality play, that it's all about crony capitalism.
So as you can say that he says it's a morality play, it's all about your morals, what you have, and how, what were the morals when you were sanctioning such a loan so easily. On the flip side, if you actually consider you and I going for a loan, they will ensure that they will suck the blood out from us. That's the thing. I remember my dad, though he was in government service, he wanted to construct one house. So way back in 99 or something, he had taken a loan of around 20 lakhs, I remember. He took almost maybe around 10 years to repay that. So 10, 12 years, but he repaid everything. But I'm saying, I remember we were in some other place in Karnataka and he had to travel to Bangalore almost every week. A government officer in a pretty good position in the Indian government service, but then you had to transfer, to go to Bangalore so many times just to get the loan approved. And his life is set actually, because he'll get pension even after retirement. But the thing is still, even for a government servant, they made him run from pillar to post for so long. And think about the other guys now who are into business or normal, like students who want student loans. And I remember after 10, 12 years after, you know, he cleared the loan off, there was a small party in our house. Because that is the level of satisfaction that you get after clearing the loan. Because we are all normal middle class, lower middle class people who are genuine, who really are hardworking, and who would definitely repay. And for them, for us, the treatment is like this. Whereas for these guys, like Vijay Mallya and all that, they'll just give left, right, center. Same Nirav Modi also. He did not even have credibility and they gave guarantees worth 10,000, 11,000, 12,000 crore. And the best part was when everything happens and the dust settles down and when there's a fraud case and when I lift the corporate veil, nobody is there. All escaped. It is very shocking that the enforcement directorate had set out a, had blacklisted Vijay Mallya and they are told that he cannot leave the country. But under everybody's noses, he left the country. Do you think he's a poor man now? No. He was a director of 47 private companies. 47 private companies is stinking rich. He was spending, I think I told you, 4 lakh rupees per week in UK now. 4 lakh rupees per week. And he said it was, it's not enough for me. Since he's seeking asylum in UK, to spend his own money has to take permission of the court. So the court had fixed a limit of 4 lakh rupees per week. He said he had the audacity to say this is not enough for my flamboyant lifestyle. Because wherever he goes, he has a house, he has a business, he has a wife, so on and so forth. So the thing is, that's what it is. It is true, I'm not kidding. So the thing is, he said it is difficult to maintain everything. So I need to obviously get money. Believe it or not, he applied to the court. And the court sanctioned, the UK court sanctioned him 16 lakh per week, 4 times. Today Vijay Mallya is spending 16 lakh per week. Just think about it. Here the loan that people are dying 9,000, 10,000 crore of your and my money. And here there is spending 16 lakh per week. And as per the recent statistics, the average annual income of an average Indian is 1.01 lakh per annum, not per month. It's the average. Take all the earnings of the our entire population divided by the population. One working population, that is 1.01 lakh per annum. And this guy is spending 16 lakh per week. And he is wanted in India. He is a fugitive economic offender. And he is standing there today. When people wanted, when the Kingfisher was going down because it had no business model, you should always remember it is the trust that you have, not in the company, but the man behind the company. He did not pay the employees for 8 months. And for 8 months, the employees worked for him. Think about it. In the second month, he came, I am your CEO. You need to trust me. I will 100% give you the salary that you want. But just, we are going through bad times now. I am the king of good times, but we are going through bad times. So please bear with me. And the trust and the sense of belonging they had towards Kingfisher, pilots did not take for 8 months. then the normal, what do you say, air hostesses and other people, everybody, the ground staff did not take salary for 8 months. That's the confidence that they had. And bank manager, he fed money, all bank managers, he fed money because he wanted the loan. And if you see the, when they are now investigating, each bank manager whose salary was some 1 lakh rupees per month have 4-5 properties in Mumbai, each valued at 40-50 crore. The question is, how did you get it? Crony capitalism. Throw money, you will get the loan sanctioned. See Chanda Kochar's case, that, you know, Videocon, 300, 400, 3000 crore loan sanctioned for kickback. What is the kickback? The moment loan was given to that Videocon immediately transferred to one more company, which was owned by Chanda Kochar's husband. So if you see, everything is crony capitalism. And the best part is, they are playing with your money and my money, whatever we deposit in the bank, thinking that it will be safe. It would be safe, no doubt about it. But what I am saying is, 91,000 crore in that ILFS is wiped out from the economy. And ultimately, it will hurt India's future prospects as an economy. That is what we need to think. Now, 1.01 lakh, and people just trusted him blindly. The employee said, Vijay Mallya has told, he will pay, means he will pay. 8 months later, lift the corporate veil, nobody is there. And from there, he is sitting and telling, I cannot come to India because the jails are not very nice. Jails are not, what do you say, very conducive for my stay. Jails have rats, I am not kidding, these are his actual dialogues. Jails, so he is choosing whether to come or not because of the conditions of the jail. And he says, if I will be treated really well, and if I am put in a good jail, then I will think of coming. Can an offender speak like that? Think, the audacity, think about it. That the jail, he is actually speaking, I am not kidding, just see the news. He tells that the jails are not very clean for my taste. So I cannot come. You do whatever you want. So they are trying to extradite him from UK. It's difficult, lot of red tapeism, lot of, you know, bureaucracy. But they are trying to do it. He has sought asylum in UK. And he now told, like recently he told, I did not take any loan. Kingfisher took, Solomon versus Solomon, CPT. Correct? I did not take any loan. I am ready to pay loan. If you are ready to pay loan, you should come to India and do it. I am ready to pay loan, no problem. So everybody hailed him as the king of good times. You and I all fell for his trick, saying that basically he was paying that, giving that free thing using our money only. So if you are taking one handful of 5-star, you had paid for it. If you are taking free pen and free book, you had paid for it. Just that we didn't know, we had paid indirectly through the loan that he had taken. And now the pilot who each pilot will earn easily 2 to 3 lakh rupees per month, where will he go now? Where would we go? That's the problem. So in India, the problem is, there are so many laws. Under which section, which act will I go and sue? Section 420 CRPC will I go? Or will I put a civil case? Will I go to NCLT? Will I go to, that time there was CLB, Company Law Board? That was the issue in our country. So if you see, he just cheated everybody. Today he is telling Solomon versus Solomon, I will not pay. And I did not take any loan, Kingfisher took loan. And Kingfisher has to pay. Kingfisher is not there only. And his Kingfisher villa in Goa, that was hailed as one of the largest villas where he used to do all his board meetings and all that. Now that property has been attached by SBI. Now next time when you are traveling to Goa, then you should plan and regularly follow the plan, Goa plan always. So if you go there you see one. Now it's sold out, but then one SBI banner was there, old SBI banner that government designed. Amazing design it will be. So that it says for sale, and it was all dusted completely, there's nothing. Now think about it. I am a normal, forget about banks guys, forget about banks. I am a pilot. Kingfisher owes me 20 lakh rupees. One pilot I'm talking about. Where will I go? Companies Act 1956, if I go, I have to go to CLB, Company Law Board. Now, where will these guys go? The companies, it's already a sick company now, nobody is paying, so the creditors will go under SICA, Sick Industrial Companies Act. Under Sick Industries Companies Act, there was a concept called BIFR, Board for Industrial and Financial Reconstruction. I'll go to BIFR. Then, there is actually a law like this, which, believe it or not, I don't know if you have heard, where can the banks go and recover money from this recovery of debts due to banks and financial institutions act, RDD BFI act? Under RDD BFI, I'll have to go to debt recovery tribunal, DRT. Then there is one more, Surfacey Act. What is Surfacey? Securitization and Reconstruction of Financial Assets and Enforcement of Security Interest Act. This is like rapping in law. Right? This, that, Conservation of Foreign Exchange and Prevention of Smuggling Activities Act. Right? Yes. Yes, it's called Surfacey. Securitization and Reconstruction of Financial Assets and Enforcement of Security Interest Act. By the time you read out the law, 1 minute gone. That's the thing. And under Surfacey or Surfacey, it was again you had your DRT, again you had NCLT, whatever. You had some authority. Companies Act 2013 came. Now we have NCLT. The poor pilot can go and put a case where? In some civil court, in some criminal court. So you will have the normal lower court, high court, supreme court. Same case, multiple authorities, cases are pending. And in civil cases, because of the number of cases pending, your number will come after 2 years. First hearing will be 2 years later. Correct? So by the time you can even think of recovering money, that is almost impossible, minimum 20-25 years. 20-25 years gone. And money, you would have spent double in getting the lawyer's fees, time value of money and all those things. Which means money once gone is gone. 91,000 crore, whatever is gone now is gone. You will never recover it. And under Surfacey, Section 13 of Surfacey. Surfacey was for what companies, by the way? It was for your creditors. So if an installment is unpaid for, 90 days, I would classify that advance as what? NPA. And then again, once it's classified as NPA, the banks will send notice demanding everybody that the borrower that has to pay. Then 60 days time is given. Within 60 days also, if you haven't paid, then the proceedings will begin. That is enforcement of security interest. And believe it or not, for that, 60% of the creditors should approve. Means what? In our Kingfisher, out of 9,000 crore, let's say SBI had 6,000 crore. I'm just giving examples. Then Vijaya Bank had around 50 crore. ICICI, I'm just giving example, 1 crore. That's it. Outstanding ICICI was 1 crore. ICICI is pushing that let's go and claim this money. But can ICICI alone go? No. It needs the approval of at least SBI should come. SBI, all the bank managers have been fed money. They are not interested. And my money didn't go. I got my money. I got 3 properties, prime properties in Mumbai. So I am not bothered. So under this act also in Surfacey, 60% of value had to even enforce after how many days? Already 180 days over. 90 days, this time I don't know. Even if you take 30 days plus 60 days. 180 days, 200 almost to actually say, please pay the money. 1 year gone almost. So where will you get the money? In that 1 year you can escape, anything can happen. Correct? Now what to do? In all these cases, cases are pending. CLB it's pending, some cases in BFR, some cases in DRT. Now the best part is High Court has, this has gone from NCLT to High Court. High Court has put a stay order on RDD BFI because it's not that, what overrides what, God only knows. So one fellow is putting a case in BIFR and High Court has brought about a stay order in this case. Pilot has brought about a stay order against Kingfisher in Companies Act, NCLT. They want to dispose of the asset. Kingfisher, the pilot says, no, stay order. So there were multiplicity of laws, lot of confusion. What to do? This had to be streamlined. What is an act and what is a code? Why is it Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code? They got bored of the word act. Insolvency, bankruptcy, at IBA. No, IBC is better. Is it like that? Why did they do this? What is the code? What does the code do? Guideline? No. If I have one more Insolvency and Bankruptcy Act, I will have an authority under it, NCLT, whatever authority. And where will it go? Again under that authority. Will that act now override other acts? No. Why? Because all these are acts only, no? See, Companies Act, Industrial Act, RDBF Act, in all these cases, what happens? They have their own authority. Under that authority, you can go ahead. One authority can actually sue the other authority, bring about a stay order through the High Court. Correct? Now, if I again have Insolvency and Bankruptcy Act, same thing will happen. I can go through IBA, and then other acts will keep on going, and again it will be no point. That's why they introduced a code. What does a code do? Code, a process of codification will happen. Process of codification. What is codification? Streamlining all the laws and bringing it under one mother law. And that mother law is Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code. Means what? The moment I go through IBC, what happens? All the cases pending in all the other laws will stop and all will come under one ambit, that is Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code. That is why if you see, in voluntary winding up, provisions only have been deleted. Why? Because you cannot have voluntary winding up anymore. There is only one type of winding up, that is winding up by the tribunal. Voluntary winding up will have to now be under the ambit of NCLT. All these sections have been amended. Companies Act 1956 is no longer there. Sick Industry Companies Act, now it says subject to IBC. RDDBFI, subject to IBC. Surface E, subject to IBC. So that is called a process of codification, streamlining all the laws and bringing into one law. It has never happened in the history of the world. We should be very, very proud of IBC. Because in all the other laws, there are multiplicity of laws going on and on. I did not have any way to ensure that one law is there. Now I have IBC. So under IBC, there are so many wordings that we need to understand. What are they? What is the difference between insolvency and bankruptcy? Winding up, liquidation, dissolution. You are bankrupt, you apply for insolvency. Okay. Then, one second. Now, I gave you that example. Kingfisher, what was it? Kingfisher had around 6,000 crore from SBI. ICICI Bank, 1 crore. Under any law, can ICICI apply? No. Surface is 60%. Sick Industry Companies Act, separate resolutions are needed. RDDBFI, again, not possible. Forget about these. These are at least secured creditors. Think about that poor pilot. Can he sue Kingfisher under any law? The only route available for him is civil court or criminal court. 20, 25 years. All this has changed with the introduction of IBC. Under IBC, if the company here is called as the corporate debtor. Company called as corporate debtor. If corporate debtor has not paid money, how much money? Any idea? How much money? You will be shocked to know that such a provision is there in our country. 1 lakh rupees. Corporate debtor means a company has not paid how much? 1 lakh rupees. To whom? To this bank, who is this bank which has given loan, is called as a financial creditor. Corporate debtor has not paid 1 lakh rupees to a financial creditor, or in any of these laws, in the old laws that you have seen here, in any of these laws, can the poor pilot come? No. Where? Industrial, Sick Industrial Companies Act? No. Companies Act, it can't go. Surface is only for secured creditors. RDDBFI is only for bank and financial institutions. The only route available for me is what? Civil court. But under IBC, they say, don't worry, I will protect you also. New category called operational creditor. Has the creditor provided money? Yes. Then he is a financial creditor. Has the creditor provided services or goods? Yes. He is a operational creditor. The pilot has provided services. How much? 1 lakh rupees. So don't you think so? This is like nipping it in the bud. I need not wait for 9 months, 8 months. First month salary not paid. Can I go to IBC? Yes. So IBC has instilled a fear, a sense of fear among the corporates now. Pay up or face the music. 1 lakh is peanuts. 1 lakh is peanuts. No, one default, no how many days. The moment you have default, today you have payment, you have not paid, tomorrow IBC. That's the fear instilled now. Fear instilled among the corporate debtors. Then, voluntary winding up means what? Company themselves going and saying, sorry, I cannot pay and all that. That was under which act? Companies Act. Voluntary winding means shareholders. Company means obviously shareholders. Here, can corporate debtor, before anybody can come, can corporate debtor, you know, remove the white flag and tell, sorry, this is it. Let me go to IBC. Yes. Third type of person is corporate debtor. This was the provision of what? Winding up by voluntary winding up. That has been removed there and inserted here. They also, if they are unable to pay amounts, they can say, sorry, time to end. The crux here is it's all 1 lakh rupees. If they are unable to pay 1 lakh rupees to either an operational creditor or a financial creditor, what do they do? Operational creditor or financial creditor, if they are unable to pay, then they will go for IBC. Corporate debtor itself can go for IBC. Correct? General rule, if I go for winding up, what will happen? All assets will be sold. And liabilities, whatever will be set off. If I am selling, saying that I am winding up, I have an asset worth 1 crore. I am selling to you today. I desperately need money. Will you pay 1 crore for it? Think about it. No. I will not pay 1 crore. It's called a distress sale. I will say I'll pay 20 lakh rupees. You either give it to me or no. You will feel at least something I am getting. Something I am getting. So I am going to stop that. Something I am getting, no, let me just sell it off and close it. Will that, if the same thing happens in IBC, why do I need IBC? Why do I need IBC? If I need the same thing, there's no point, right? So corporate debtor is there, operational creditor is there, financial creditor is there. These three, it's fine. But once I apply to IBC, what will happen? Once I apply to IBC, then will they be sold immediately and all that? See the wordings here, it's all negative. Sick Industrial Companies Act. Recovery of debts due to banks. Surface E. So if it's all negative, there was no concept of recovery. Everything ended in one thing, winding up. If I say BIFR, Board for Industrial and Financial Reconstruction, that was like a protective mechanism. You never could do anything more than that. Recovery of debts due to banks, the DRT, Debt Recovery Tribunal, never used to give you any opportunity. It was never possible for you to recover any money. It was impossible. Similarly, in Surface E, ultimately it would all result in winding up. And in winding up, what will happen? My 50 crore worth of assets, I'll sell it off at 50 lakhs or 1 crore, 2 crore and close the deal. If IBC also has the same provision, then it's like all the provisions coming together under one law and same thing happening there also. No, IBC is something way different. In IBC, who all can apply as I discussed now? So, corporate debtor, financial creditor, operational creditor can apply. Will I apply to CLB, BIFR, DRT, NCLT, High Court, Supreme Court? One authority only, a special bench of NCLT, who is only gonna hear what cases? IBC cases. Would apply to NCLT. Now something very amazing happens here. In the old laws, in all these laws, if I put into Sick Industrial Companies Act, if I put into Recovery of Debts Due to Banks Act, who will be the directors? Vijay Mallya or somebody else? Vijay Mallya only. Who will be in Surface Act? Who will be the director? Vijay Mallya only. When there already there is pressure for him to pay and then you are putting additional pressure under various laws, do you think he will have the mindset to actually ensure that the company recovers, or he'll say, just close it, man, just sell it off and close it. Just say sell and close it. That's why if you see, they have attached the property of that Kingfisher villa. They have also attached, they wanted to sell the logo, Kingfisher logo, one person also didn't buy. Not even one person bought the logo. Base price was some 2 crores. Bidding opened, no bidders came online. At least they'll come online, tell, okay, 2 crore, one, nothing. No bidders online. It was a humiliating, bidding process. Vijay Mallya and bidder were sitting, that's it, the auctioneer, that's it, nobody else. In fact, SBI, the government did it, bidding, nobody came. No one wants anything to do with the logo. The same person was the king of good times 2 years ago. In UB city, he had a, swanky office. And he used to give out, there were some serviced apartments there, and he used to sell them by invitation only. And he had the audacity to put it in the first newspaper ad, first page, saying that houses for sale only by invitation. Don't even see this ad if you don't have the invite. Why would you put up on the first page of the newspaper and spend so much money when you're only it is selling by invite? Think about the audacity of that guy, right? And he had an F1 team also, everything, he put his hand everywhere. That's the thing. And the best part is, it took your money to do it. He took your money, he minted money and he left. He took salary every year, Ramse, and today he is there thinking that he doesn't feel like coming to India, as if it's an obligation. Doesn't feel like coming to India because he feels that the jail conditions are very bad. And he's spending 16 lakhs per week. So we allowed him to hoodwink us and we gave him the title King of Good Times. We are the reason, and of course all the middle class dream was shattered. It was just there for some time. After that it was shattered. And we allowed it to happen. That is why India economy will never grow. Economy may get strong. Where is our rupee? 70 rupees, 75 rupees, $1 we are paying still. Why can't it get stronger? Because of these scams, if it's happening, 91,000 crore money going, 40,000 crore money going, and you will never be able to recover it ever again in your life. Not possible. So this is the scene that is happening. So under IBC, the entire thing changes. Now one more thing. I am a person, I have taken some money from my friend. Our friends don't know, you pay macha today, you pay for this lunch. Your other friend will actually enter everything in splitwise. There's that app. He'll enter everything in splitwise. In the end, he'll see, boss, today also, shameless fellow, today also you're eating food. You have to pay some 1380 rupees, man. Hey, today I don't have money, you pay today. So, okay, I'll add it in splitwise. Today lunch also sorted. Now I have to pay you 1500 rupees or something. Tomorrow, I get a notice from you, IBC. IBC of what? My insolvency. Is it valid? What I'm indirectly asking is it only company or also individual? Like I owe you 1,500 rupees. IBC also applies to individuals. And the money is, I am not kidding, 1,000 rupees. So all friends, please settle the split wise today. Yes. You settle it today. I am not kidding. You can sue another person under IBC route if he owes you 1,000 bucks and he has not paid you. IBC is a very, very strict law. Correct? So IBC is very, if you can prove to NCLT that fellow owes you money, that's it. 1,000 bucks. Then they'll come, stipend. Then they'll come and take away your clothes one by one. That's the thing. This is not yet notified though still. But it's there. I'm just saying. Why I'm telling you this? It is also there, but it's not there in your syllabus for the exam, it won't come. Even May 20, whatever, until it comes. They are still not notified it. It will take some time because they are figuring out this only properly. It's the first time ever this is happening. So even individuals are also covered, mind you. Partnership firms are also covered. Partnership firms and individuals, how much? 1,000 bucks. Not notified. So whatever it is, please settle with your friends immediately. Otherwise, 1,000 is the limit that they have done. For companies, how much? 1 lakh. It's a preemptive measure. If Kingfisher was there today, I could have threatened. Earlier, if the pilot went, means the Vijay Malaya said, get out, you can't do anything. Go put civil case, 20 years, you die. By that time, you only would have died anyway. Your son would have been a pilot, your daughter would have been a pilot by that time. So go. But now you see, pilot can go and tell, boss, where is my money? And it's a preemptive measure. If you don't give me my money, because I have to give a notice. If you don't give me money in 1 week, I'll go for insolvency. That's it. So I'm not kidding. I'll show you a case. I am not kidding. If you see, 1 second. Yeah, check this out. Office assistant drags company into insolvency. Real case. NCLT initiates action for non-payment of what? Salary dues. This is the power of NCLT and this is the power of IBC. The Chennai bench of NCLT has initiated the CIRP under the insolvency against a company based petition by an office assistant for non-payment of salary dues amounting to 3.2 lakh. Pradeep MR, office assistant, was classified as what? Operational creditor. Where are you seeing all this in our country now? It was never possible before. Otherwise, to recover 3.2 lakhs, I have to die behind the HR team, then go to civil court. For that 3.2 lakhs, I have to spend 20-25 years. Now I said, boss, I'm threatening you, you pay, otherwise IBC. The company immediately paid. They had the money somewhere, they immediately paid. My question is, why would they pay? And you see, this is a couple of years ago only, 267 petitions as on 31st August 2017, couple of years ago. As on that day itself, 267, vendors 133, employees 15, other categories 19, unknown category 100. Operational creditors only 267 cases filed across the country. This was 2 years ago. Now it has tripled or quadrupled. Now what is the problem? In all the other cases, guys, you tell me, in all the other cases, in SICA, in RDDBFI and all that, will Vijay Mallya, anything happen to Vijay Mallya? No, he will still continue. Nothing will happen to him. Nothing will happen to him. He will still continue. And when the same fellows who committed default are there, will they be interested in recovering any money? No. They'll just say, okay, we'll try to do something and all that. Now, here, think about this operational creditor, pilot. Pilot will knock on NCLT's door and say, sir, 1 lakh rupees not paid, 2 lakh rupees not paid. NCLT will say, is it true? They'll see all the documentation, then they'll say, yes. Now the best part happens. The NCLT will open the door of Kingfisher. Who is sitting there? Vijay Mallya and all his other members. They are sitting. The pilot can walk in and all the other fellows, no, like for example, King, this, what is SBI, 6,000 crore. Kingfisher has not paid 6,000 crore to SBI. Kingfisher has not paid 2 lakhs to Pilot. When Pilot is filing the case, can SBI come and tell, why are you filing, man? No. Correct? Not possible. And when the door is opened, correct? NCL, can Kingfish say, SBI, you have eaten money properly, no? Can SBI managers come and say, sir, this is not right, nobody can apply like that. I only have not applied 6,000 crore. NCLT will say, shut up and join the queue. Simple. If you want money, join the queue. That's the power. 1 lakh. I don't care who applies. Maybe a financial creditor or operational creditor. Because of the strength of this 1 lakh ka petition filed by operational creditor, I told you ICICI Bank 1 crore, they will be the second in line. 1 crore is 1 crore, they'll come. Now the best part happens. Like that, all the creditors line up. They enter the company. This is the first time ever in the history of the world. They enter the company and they'll ask Vijay Mallya and his entire board of directors to get out. Complete suspension of the board of directors. Complete suspension. Can Vijay Mallya bring a stay order from High Court? No. The moment NCLT opens the door, you used to play that game in childhood, no? Statue. Right? NCLT stands up and says statue. Means what statue? All statue here. Sikh industry, BIFR statue. CLB statue. DRT statue. High Court, Supreme Court statue. Nobody can do anything. And that nobody can do anything for the period till which issue is settled. See the power, guys. Even Supreme Court can't do anything. He will tell, I am the Supreme Court, Supreme Most Authority, statue, done, over. That's it. Nothing can be done. The moment for, you are you understanding the amount here? 2 lakh rupees, Kingfisher Pilot didn't get the money. And NCLT accepted it, like this personal assistant, that whatever, office assistant, 3.2 lakhs. And he said statue, even if 6,000 crore case is pending, it's a statue only. And that statue legally is called moratorium. The NCLT will put statue and all, don't write, please. Yeah, I'll impose moratorium. While writing it comes, all those things don't write. So, moratorium. Moratorium means a temporary suspension of activity. What activity? All legal activity, statue. You will not, no case will go on. You can't give, bring any, what do you say, stay order. SBI can't come and show that I am 6,000 crore, stay away, get back, nothing. You say, 1 lakh fellow is there, go behind and, you know, decently get, enter into the company. And what happens once you enter the company? Suspension of the board of directors. They are all suspended. As you know the power of 179, whatever the company could have done, board can do, is now subject to IBC. It is the first time ever where the creditors will now sit around the table. Creditors will manage. When your money is involved, won't you put your heart and soul? Yes. When other people's money is involved, Vijay Mallya would have still been, anyway, Sikh Industries Act has gone, let my company become sicker, sickest and then die. Right? That's all, simple as that. I don't have to go anywhere further, anyway it's gone. Winding up is going on, for me nothing will happen, I know I'll escape, no problem. Correct? That's why this case was one of the landmark cases, because of Vijay Mallya all these things came. But this is not applicable to Vijay Mallya, unfortunately. I'm just giving example. He escaped. But now going forward, all the cases are covered under IBC. Got it? Now, suspension of board of directors. I'll just complete the process, then you can ask any doubt you have. So, what happens? Suspension of board of directors. Complete suspension. Then who will sit? Creditors will sit around the table. Will Pilot also sit? That is little too much, man. small shareholder director. Bringing him, entering, asking him to enter the company only is a big thing, right? I've at least given so much power. But I'll tell the pilot, sit there around, say, food is kept, eat. Don't worry, now we'll take over. Who is the we? Financial creators. Big shots. Who can kick the door open? Pilot. That was never there before. Correct? Kicking the door open is the pilot. But he can just take a back seat now and relax. Operational creator. They do not have the power to sit on the table. Who can sit on the table? Financial creator. Because ultimately, if you think about it, it's the loan that I've given that matters. Services always come second. But still, they are still covered. No doubt about it. They will also get the payment. Now, these guys will have to rack their brains and come out with a plan. Plan to do what? Reform the company, rehabilitate the company. Are you seeing the changes here? In the old, all the laws, recovery of debt. I'm only thinking of recovery. I'm only thinking of sick industry. I'm only thinking of how to wind up. Here, the idea only is different. Idea is to revive. The company is good. Kingfisher is good. The business model will change it. Why do you want to completely throw everything under the bus? Let's not do it. Let's just recover something. How? Let me bring in a new management. Let me bring in new management. Indigo is waiting. Or let's say assume that time Jet Airways was waiting. Correct? Etihad Airlines is, Qatar Airlines is waiting. They want to come and take over. So these fellows will rack their brains and they will open up the company for auction. Whoever wants to come and buy can come and buy. You will never see this anywhere before. And each of the fellows are called resolution applicant. I am just giving you the basics today. Overview. Resolution applicant. What can they come and do? This is my plan. Take it. Please allow me to take over the company. Who gets to decide? Creditors. They are called as COC, Committee of Creditors. Those who have been sitting there around the table. Shareholders will suddenly come and tell, I appointed under 152 to Vijay Mallya. And I appointed under 160, 161, all that first cluster, second cluster, I appointed. I will remove you under 169. NCLT says statue. Correct? So, for those days, board also is suspended. Shareholders also suspended. No powers. Who is the board? Who is the shareholder? Committee of creditor. Committee of creditors. So it's some insane law. You would have never seen like this. Then the resolution applicant will come one by one. All that, they'll come one by one. They'll come, they'll give. Then they'll arms and discuss. And then finally approve. They'll approve one plan properly. This is the best plan for us. Can they directly implement? No. They again have to go to whom? NCLT. That plan is called as resolution plan. That full plan, no, that's called resolution plan. I'll go to NCLT. Resolution plan, they'll see everything. Okay, it's already approved by the committee. Good. Yes, this sounds feasible. Let's go ahead with it. If they say, let's go ahead with it, then what happens? The company will go towards recovery, rehabilitation. In this resolution plan, what all will be there? The new company, Qatar Airways is coming. First thing that they are going to do is what? Pay off the secured creditors. How much percentage plan will have? They'll pay off the operational creditors. How much percentage plan will have? Or I'll give you shares in Qatar Airways. Please come. I'll give the plan. That's the plan. In the olden other laws, 90,000 crore gone means gone. No scene of recovery. In the new law, the person who is coming to take over has to actually repay the banks. Means money is coming back into the system. And the beauty is, I will not wait till the company commits this fraud or this whatever misappropriate to such an extent of crores, 1 lakh rupees. In the initial signs of distress, I can kick the door open and come in. Not when it is too late. When it is already 80,000 crore loss already, what you will do? Nobody will revive. But in initial stages of, you know, problem, 1 lakh rupees, I can kick the door open. It's a wonderful law. So first of all, it's a preemptive measure initially only. And second of all, what? A new person coming in should say, how much I'll pay? Okay, 80% I'll pay, 100 I can't pay. At least you're getting 80%. If you sold the assets, you will get 10%. So the money is being pumped into the economy again. Revival of company also, revival of economy also. And don't wait till you die, almost. Wait during the initial signs of distress. Two wonderful things. General rule, all this would have taken 20-25 years. Here they say that statue is for how long? 180 days, that's it. Roughly 6 months. I will only give you 6 months time. The moment you enter the company, let's not use 6 months, 180 days. In 180 days, what should you do? Kick out Vijay Mallya, you sit there, you see how the seat is and all, and then later form the committee. And what should the committee do? Start accepting resolution plans from resolution applicants. Scrutinize everything, decide, and then go to the NCLT and say, sir, please approve. Suppose you could not do it within 180 days. One time extension of 90 days. One time extension of 90 days. Totally making it 270 days. Where have you seen a law whereby a new company comes, takes it over, revives everything in just less than a year? Pumps money into the economy in just less than a year. And this resolution applicant, you only have some 1,000 NPA accounts in all banks. Can you become and pay money? No. Ineligibility criteria and all has been added now. You are a promoter. You didn't pay. Vijay Mallya, can he come and buy Kingfisher? Correct? What do you think? He has hidden money somewhere. Now suddenly he came. I'll take. All that is there. We'll see all that. It's all going forward. But what I'm saying is the basic. Recovery. Now the best part is you either go for recovery and complete rehabilitation or things don't work. NCLT feels this is one stupid plan, man, leave it. Then what to do? If the plan is stupid or either nobody comes to buy, then finally I have liquidation. Correct? No, nothing can be done. What can I do? I have at least tried something. And 99% of the cases, somebody will come to buy. Because at the end, the foundation is very strong. Rather than starting from scratch, let me buy a company which is already good. I just have to tweak here and there, I'll make it a wonderful company. Qatar wanted to buy Jet Airways. Jet Airways IBC is going on, by the way. Qatar has its eyes. Etihad has his eyes on Jet Airways. Already had it eye, one more. Two eyes it has now. Correct, correct. So if we say one eye it had, two eyes. It wants to buy, but again the FDI norms are very strict. It will become a foreign airline then. So that is one problem. That is Pakistan and all won't come. They can't afford. Can afford the toys from China. That one, if you just pull it back, it will go, no? That remote control one. Yes, so recovery and liquidation. These are the two things. Now after this 180 plus 90, what to do? Liquidation. Now this liquidation, whatever was there in Companies Act, gone. The liquidation is as per IBC liquidation, totally different. You see, remember in BCom you did that priority of payment, all that is different here. This they asked in the last attempt, I knew it would come. I told also in the crash course it will come, 6 marks question they asked. The priority of payments, May 2019 paper, priority of payments. Now this entire thing, no. 180 plus 90, whatever they come, that is called as CIRP. Corporate Insolvency Resolution Process. Corporate Insolvency Resolution Process. At the end of CIRP, what happens? Either recovery happens or liquidation. So what are the two things in my IBC? One is CIRP, one more is liquidation. One is CIRP, one more is liquidation. From November 19 onwards, liquidation process has been removed. What is removed? Liquidation process removed. So what should you know? Only and only CIRP. They'll ask you questions on the procedure and all those things. They'll ask corporate insolvency resolution process. Got it? Now, why are we discussing all these things? Do you think the creditors will have the skill to sit across the table, discuss, create the plan and all those things? No. Do you think the pilot will know what to do? No. Correct? He can only bring the plane and land that's there. But obviously, this legal aspects, he has to hire somebody. Correct? And even this committee of creditors, who are the committee of creditors? Creditors won't come and sit. They have to hire somebody. Who is the somebody? You guys. That's the reason why we are sitting and dying here with this. Who is that somebody who sits in Vijay Mallya's seat? It is not the creditor. It is a representative of the creditor. That is who? You. Who is that fellow called? Insolvency. Insolvent professional, don't write. Insolvency. At as of now, stipend. Insolvent professionals. In the making. Insolvency professional. Correct? Or ideally, IRP they say. Insolvency resolution professional. IRP is a chartered accountant, company secretary, lawyer who has experience. Even if he doesn't have experience, he has to pass an exam called as the National Insolvency Exam, which is nothing but your allied law, economic law. So you can do it. It is a lucrative profession. Many lawyers have left their law practice and jumped into this wagon, everybody. And even this, you know, CA, CS, SW, just one small exam it is, ticking like CPT. Negative marking is 60% pass percentage. Not pass percentage, sorry, what I meant was the pass marking is 60%. But it's actually easy, it is all the economic laws only, company law of course. So if you are good in law, obviously doing it immediately after the exam, you can actually write National Insolvency Exam. And you will now be be eligible to be what? Insolvency resolution professional. What will you be doing? Pilot will come to you. You need to apply. And you need to get inside. And you need to throw Vijay Mallya out. You need to sit on the chair. And you need to conduct the first meeting of the COC. And guess what is the first item of business in the first meeting of COC? My fees. And it has to be paid immediately. Yes, it has to be paid. Because till then, I am an interim resolution professional. In the COC meeting, the entire committee will actually decide on actual resolution professional. It can be me, it can be anybody. I said, first give me my money and then do whatever you want. Correct? And the first, okay, that's also fine. Let's say I go, somebody else you appoint in that COC meeting, resolution professional. He tries for 180 days, nothing happens. At the end of 180 days, what happens? Liquidation. Liquidation, when they sell the asset, the first rupee should go to you. Insolvency resolution. We will now be called as liquidator. So if you see, money is guaranteed and they charge percentage. Percentage of recovery. It's all decided by COC. Very, very lucrative. That's the reason why people are now going for this insolvency, National Insolvency Exam. Anybody can go. Can a BCom graduate do it? Yes, there's a criteria. BCom graduate with 15 years experience. Not in writing BCom exam. 15 years experience in whatever, you know, banking, some 3-4 criteria they have given. No, but that is what? There are two exams. One is what? National Insolvency Exam. One is Limited Insolvency Exam. Limited, there are exemptions from few papers and few topics. National insolvency exam, anybody can write, including a freshly qualified BCom graduate. But it will be very tough for him because it requires CA final level knowledge. Correct? That's why I am saying do it off immediately after CA final. It actually helps. If you have taken economic law, elective and all, this is a breeze. You can aram se pass. Right? So, national insolvency exam is one. Limited insolvency exam is, you know, you have the exemption. This exemption is what? CA or CS and all who have 10 years experience. Not in writing the exam again. 10 years experience in the industry. Not practice. 10 years experience. Either in practice or industry. Doesn't matter. For BCom, that exemption is BCom 15 years. Why 15 years? 5 years we are doing CA, no? That's it. Tally. Correct? That's why 15 years. So that is why 15 years. Logic, they also have logic there. So that's the thing. So limited insolvency exam, CA, CS is 10 years, BCom. That is limited, some exemptions are there. Otherwise, everybody, you just cleared your CA exam, you have to write national insolvency examination. Like me, I cleared in 2012. Even I have to write the national insolvency exam. Sorry, no. No open book. It's just like your normal, MCQ. MCQ and no written and all, just MCQ, you can pass. As I told you, CA final law, CA final old syllabus allied law, CA final new syllabus economic law elective. If you have taken that, aram se you can pass. And one or two here and there other chapters will be there, but easily you can pass and very, very lucrative. And not that you will now be handling insolvency of big companies, you can join a company which is already there. Into all these things. Many companies have actually shifted their practice. All law firms that I have seen, all they are minting money here. They are minting money because recovery is happening. People are coming and taking over. Now, this is the best thing that happened. Now, who controls all these things? Like, for example, who is the regulator? There should be one regulator. NCLT is the authority, adjudicating authority. Now, one best thing can happen now. If you are not happy with the NCLT decision, that statute is there, no, that statute is for 180 plus 90 days, 270. But here, NCLT says, no, the resolution plan is bad. Can I appeal against the NCLT? Yes. It is just NCLT, NCLAT, Supreme Court, that's it. High Court has no power. High Court has no power. So, I have what? NCLT, NCLAT, Supreme Court, and I stop. High Court, absolutely no power. Single window. For securities market, I have SEBI. For banks, I have RBI. For insolvency, I have IBBI. Insolvency and Bankruptcy Board of India. Wordings are important. Insolvent and Bankrupt Board of India, no. Insolvency and Bankruptcy Board of India. IBBI. They are the regulating authority. Now, just like our Aadhaar card for individuals, there is one more number that is coming up for all the corporate entities. Again, to cut down crony capitalism, I have these data banks which will give me that number. So from now, if I want a loan, they'll ask which company and they'll ask me for that number. When I put in that number, my entire history, geography, everything will come out of that company. When did you take money? Which all banks it is pending? What did you do? Why didn't you repay? And it will throw up to the bankers so that they can take an informed choice before giving any loan. This one more thing is happening. This data is being stored by large company. When I'm saying data stored by means the service providers of storing this data are companies whose net worth is around 500 crore. Huge companies. There's a wonderful concept and this is called IU, Information Utility. Sorry? Yes, credit report, everything. They will give credit report. And the thing is here, I don't know. See, for example, Vijay Mallya had already defaulted on one payment, but the other bank gave him 25 crore. How? Personally also on some loan he had defaulted and the company also had defaulted, still he got 300 crore loan from I think Vijaya Bank or something. How is it possible? So now it says IU, you have to take approval of this IU, information utility, which gives you all the details of the last whatever number of years, what loan did you take, when were you supposed to pay, why didn't you pay, whether it was rescheduled, everything. Yes, so correct, interoperability has started now. That is the reason why it will be, see, first I told you I have already given a loan and initial signs of financial distress. Now I am saying before giving a loan only stop it. Before giving a loan stop it, because everything is linked to this database maintained by IU, information utility. So we are moving towards an India where I will recognize potential Vijay Mallya cases, potential Kingfisher cases, check the, what do you say, sanctity or the credibility of your business plan, business model, and then decide whether you really deserve the money or not. This has never happened anywhere. And it starts off with a very small amount, 1 lakh rupees. And this is initial signs of financial distress, no waiting till you die almost. Then there's no point, I have to kill you, nobody will come and, you know, take over your company. But here, if your company is good but it's going down, let me bring a better management to come and change the way things are done. Because you don't know how to manage the show, I will manage the show. This is the first law ever where a creditor is coming and taking possession after there is non-payment, not a debtor. Creditor himself is coming and taking over possession, suspending the board of directors. When your money is involved, you will put your heart and soul into it and ensure the company is revived. And it will definitely help in the development of our country, in a sense where new companies will come over and the good, solid, liquid companies with strong management will come over and take over and first repay everything. Maybe 60%, 70%, but they'll repay. And economy money is pumped in and that company will become double powerful because this good company with a solid foundation has been added to their company now. So if I want to summarize everything, if you see here, yeah, it is now insolvency, bankruptcy, winding up, liquidation, all what are the small differences? Insolvency and bankruptcy are almost the same, just that bankruptcy is like a legal term, but in the context of IBC, insolvency can be, before IBC, general rule, insolvency is a feeling where your, or a condition or situation where your liabilities are far in excess of the assets. It is a feeling of, what do you say, helplessness where I cannot pay, like articleship, full 3 years. I want to do so many things, but there is no money, right? That is insolvency. Bankruptcy is what? Legally, when I go to the court and say, please declare me bankrupt. Please declare that today I am bankrupt. That is bankruptcy. But in the context of IBC, insolvency is the term used for companies. Bankruptcy is the term used for firms and individuals. That is why it is called as Insolvency and Bankruptcy Act. No, code. Codification of law. All the laws are streamlined into one mother law and no other section will apply. Winding up is the entire process where a company closes down. Liquidation is each and every step in that process. The company has initiated winding up proceedings, they say. Step number one, step number two, step number three, it means I am doing liquidation. Right? The company is going for winding up, they say. Then step number one, step number two, step number three is called liquidation. Dissolution is the final nail in the coffin. When I say company is dissolved, what does it mean? I have struck off the name from the register of, you know, companies. I have struck down the company. That is called dissolution. That is called dissolution. That would be called as dissolution. Now, if you see here, who is the regulator? Already discussed regulatory mechanism. I have Insolvency and Bankruptcy Board of India, who has two. One is Insolvency Professional Agency. This is the agency conducting the examination. Where do I have to go? Vasant Nagar, ICAI. ICAI, ICSI, ICMI are the insolvency professional agency bodies conducting the examination. Who are the guys who are going to decide the show? You. So each creditor can appoint an insolvency professional who will walk into the company, throw Vijay Mallya out and sit across the table. So it's like a group of professionals sitting across the table and discussing how to revive the company. That is why it is important. That's why some 10 marks will come from IBC. Because you need to know at the end of the day, what is the first thing that they'll discuss? All group of professionals. How many attempts did you take? Right? And then second one is what? First attempt, second attempt, third attempt, which rank? What are your marks? What were your marks in law? Old syllabus, what are your marks in ISKA? Right? And finally, what ultimately first thing is the remuneration. That is what they're gonna decide. Insolvency professional. Then I told you IU. Information utility. This is the database that is going to help in the future. This is not even a preemptive measure. It is a complete preventive measure. Where before even giving to potential Vijay Mallyas, don't give. So because of this law, our economy is going to completely change. This is a big feather in the cap for the BJP government. Because under BJP government, this law came. They pushed for it and it is a reality. And honestly, it has really changed the dynamics of banking and the concept of loan in our country. So credit where credit is due. They created it, they pushed for it, and they passed the legislation. And it has changed the dynamics of the country. This was one of the main reasons why BJP won the elections as well. One of the main reasons from the economy point of view, this is one of the trump card. One of the trump cards that the government had. Anyway, next, adjudicating authority is who? Now, for corporates, LLP and personal guarantees related to corporate, as we'll come to it, NCLT, NCLAT and Supreme Court. For individuals and partnerships, see in the old act this was there, no? This debt recovery tribunal under RDD, BFI Act and all. Now that DRT, they have said you don't handle all cases, you handle only individual cases. DRT, DRAT, Supreme Court. Debt Recovery Tribunal, Debt Recovery Appellate Tribunal, Supreme Court. No High Court in the scene anywhere. No High Court in the scene anywhere. Right? So this is the entire mechanism. This one, they are not there yet. This is not there. That is still not there. What is not there? The need for the law, if you see the need, it was to consolidate and amend the law relating to reorganization and insolvency. What all did they amend? All those laws that we discussed. And in a time-bound manner. Why time-bound? 180 plus 90. For maximization of the value of assets. Yes, I am not going to simply squander the assets by throwing it at dirt cheap rates. And by the way, when the new fellow comes and takes over, he can't take it at some 30%, 40%. What should happen? Valuation should happen. Market value should take. Right? To promote entrepreneurship. Why? Creditors are becoming entrepreneurs now. Of course, through the insolvency professionals. Balance the interests of all stakeholders and so establish the IBBI. Insolvency Bankruptcy Board of our country is the main reason why the law. One more main reason why the law came was withering away of multiplicity of laws. Right? The Presidency Towns Insolvency Act was there, Provincial Insolvency Act, Indian Partnership Act, Companies Act, SICA, Companies Act 2013, RDD, BFI, SARFAESI. Everything is amended. Everything is amended now. Rehabilitation, revival is nothing but IBC. So that entire chapter is removed. Voluntary winding up. Corporate are himself going. Covered under IBC. Why again this Companies Act? Nobody will go to Companies Act again. So gone. Then SARFAESI again amended. Everywhere amended. So RDDBFI is DRT. So in RDDBFI, what is the amendment? Subject to individual and partnership firm insolvency. They are put there. Bankruptcy. That's the thing. If I want to see the applicability of the code, preliminary. Yeah. And you see this. Insolvency resolution and bankruptcy for individuals and partnership firms, part number 3. Remember, Partnership Act is applicable to CPT. whole of India except Jammu and Kashmir, CPT days. Correct? So when partnership act only is applicable to whole of India except J&K, liquidation of partnership act firms also applies to whole of India except Jammu and Kashmir. This is a very peculiar law. Some parts applies to whole of India, some parts apply to except J&K. Part 4 and part 5 is all the procedures. What they ask in the exam is part number 2 in that one part. What is that? Insolvency, resolution and liquidation of corporate persons. In that, liquidation is removed. But we will still do it in 10 minutes. Okay, we'll do it. Insolvency resolution is what is there. What is there in the exam? CIRP. Corporate Insolvency Resolution Process. Corporate Insolvency Resolution Process. It is all that we have in the exam. Part 3 not yet notified. I repeat, part 3 not yet notified. Part 4 is just the normal regulation here and there. Part 5 is miscellaneous. Check out. What are the features of the code? First of all, it's a comprehensive law, where the other multiplicity of laws have been withered away. All those 10-15 laws are gone. One window clearance and one chain of authority. NCLT, NCLAT, Supreme Court. No other other courts coming and putting stay order, nothing doing. Clarity in process, that we will see tomorrow from all the charts. It's very, very simple, very, very clear. Low time resolution, 180 plus 90. And for small companies and for startups, before it starts only it's ending means, for such companies, why 180 plus 90? There is one more which I knew it would ask, they would ask in the exam, again they ask, fast track insolvency. This only is fast track. It's like us taking regular batch, fast track batch, crash course batch. Fast track is 10 days, crash course is 6 days, 3 days, 5 days. That's the thing. Bangalore people want fast track. Unfortunate, but they don't want to come and aram say 10, 30, 30, 40 days, they want fast track everywhere. But yeah, we have to give in to the demands of the time. And we know how to compress everything into 7. Then they want crash course also. 10 days don't want, I can only afford 5 days for law, your dabba subject, 5 days. You come, you teach everything in 5 days. Okay, fine, we'll teach, no problem. So, crash course is one more thing. So, fast track insolvency, that's what, exactly half. 90 and 45. Fast track insolvency. Next, new regulatory authority. Who is that? IBBI. Insolvency and Bankruptcy Board of India. And establishment of IU. And what does it do? Protects the interests of the employees and workmen. This is the full procedure of what? My IBC. This is the overview. This is the overview. So, tomorrow anyway, we will be discussing the process and I have prepared one master chart which I will be sharing with you on the group. So, this master chart again will give me the entire overview of the IBC in one simple chart that I will be sending the full process. So, if you see this process, we will share with you. So, it's full procedure, application, admittance, communication, appointment, IRP, public announcement, all that. And in the end, what happens? Whether you accept or reject. Then that's the thing. Full CIRP takes how many days? 180 days. So we shall see that tomorrow. I appreciate your patience, guys. You're dying here since 1 minute. I'll leave, Yeah. Oh, 1 minute. That fellow, first of all, is visiting student. Now he wants to leave. Anyway, I'll leave. Thank you so much. The thing is, slide I'll put 1 second. Let them. So thank you guys for your, cooperation. And you've sat through for almost like 5 hours. Brilliant. Have a nice Sunday. Nothing is left in the Sunday. You guys have one more class now, by the way?
Yes.
Enjoy. See you.